One of the biggest challenges of being a content creator is filming epic B-roll of yourself, because most likely you don't have the luxury of someone just tagging along all day to film you. So that's why I thought that in today's episode, I would teach you guys how to shoot and edit dynamic B-roll of yourself. Following along on my 7-day daily vlog challenge, you might have seen that in day 7, I headed to Helsinki and I had the chance to take a Tesla from Beast Rentals to go and visit a friend. If you haven't heard of Beast Rentals before, they're an amazing company here in Europe that's offering short-term and long-term rentals of Teslas, and I was privileged enough to grab one for the day. And I wanted to take some cool photos and video of me with the Tesla, and I literally had 1 hour to shoot everything. And I was by myself, so all I had was my Sony a7S III, a tripod, and a drone to take all the shots that you guys just saw beforehand. And I wanna go with you guys and break it down just how I thought about going into this shoot and how I got the clips that I needed for my reels. So tip number one for shooting dynamic B-roll of yourself is to create movement yourself. Now, most likely when you're filming yourself, you're gonna be filming with a camera and a tripod, which means that this shot is gonna be static. It's not gonna be moving or following you. So instead of creating movement with the camera, you can create movement yourself. So I thought, for example, with these Tesla shots, I'm gonna do shots of me walking into the scene, getting into the car, creating movement and making the shot a lot more dynamic. If I would have just had the static shot of the camera, the tripod, and then me just standing statically in the shot, I think it would have made for quite a boring video. So that's why I thought, at least if the camera's not moving, I can at least be moving in the shots and create that dynamic movement. Tip number two is create movement in post. Now, because you're filming with just a camera tripod, your shot is gonna be static, but you can add movement in post. What I like to do often in a lot of my clips is just to add a subtle zoom in or pushing out for my shot, anywhere from 7 to 10%, or depending on the length of the clip, I might do a longer or more of a zoom, but I like to just have a really subtle look. I don't wanna overdo this effect, but I just wanna create a little bit of zoom just to create a little bit more motion and movement in my shot. Mixing in the movement of me walking with a little bit of zoom with the camera just makes a nice pairing together to get a little bit more dynamic shot. Tip number three is mix in dynamic detail shots. Because when you're filming shots of yourself, you're gonna have to be using the tripod with a camera on it, meaning it's not gonna be very dynamic, it's gonna be just a static shot, but that doesn't mean that when you're filming the detail shots that you can't do movement, because at that point, you're the one holding the camera and everything goes. So I found with this video of the Tesla, I try to do a lot more movement when I'm filming with the camera myself, just to get a lot more dynamicness to the video. I love just moving left to right, or sometimes, you know, for example, that Beast Rentals, I was going left and then just panned quickly to the right. And having that nice motion just creates a little bit more dynamicness to the video. And tip number four, utilize drones. Having a drone with you can be a really powerful tool when you're filming by yourself, because not only can you get nice landscape shots to just introduce the place where you're at, but as well, you can use a drone to film yourself. In this reels video, the opening shot is filmed with the drone, and the last two shots of the video are filmed with a drone. So for the first shot, I did a nice pan from left to right with the drone, and the last two shots, I was following the drone to get that nice car shot. Now, I was filming the drone while driving. I would not recommend this for people. I was being very safe by driving on an empty road, no cars around. And the way I was doing it is I just set up the drone and then I just push with one hand, but not looking at the screen anymore. I wouldn't recommend for you guys to do this, but if you're doing it in a safe way, you can get some really cool, epic shots. But there you go. That is how I shot a dynamic video all by myself of myself using a Tesla car. It is totally possible to get nice footage of yourself. You just get creative with the tools that you have and use it to your advantage. If you guys have any questions about this shoot or the video that I created, I'd love to answer those questions. So I'll be in the comments section in the next hour. So see you there.
By the way, had you enjoyed this video's audio? I'm using the FX3 with the audio handle and the Rode NTG5 mic.
Hopefully this will make a lot of you guys happy who have been complaining about the audio.